Hey YouTube, welcome to another 2 for 2 video, and today's topic is being single in Vancouver. For those who watch impsquared on a weekly basis, you already know that we filmed the Vancouver Talks video about being single in Vancouver, where we were on Granville Street in downtown Vancouver, asking people and asking them what it's like to be single in Vancouver. My two cents on this, I've been single for a while. I would say 6 or 7 years now in Vancouver. I really don't remember the last relationship I had. I've gone on a lot of dates and I've gone on a lot of hangouts. Nothing that would build a strong connection for me to go and actually pursue dating and maybe a long-term relationship. With that said, I don't really believe Vancouver's that difficult to date in or to have a relationship in. If you're single in Vancouver and you're having difficulties finding someone, maybe lower your standard. Maybe be less picky. Just give it a go with someone. Just go on dates. Open up to them. Because you never know if someone's going to surprise you. You can't judge a book by its cover and you can't judge someone by their looks. So give it a try. Try to connect. If you stop paying attention to your phone, stop distracting yourself from people, I think you'll find more connections and people that are similar to you, that you like, and that you may want to pursue a relationship with. Stop distracting yourself. Get out there. Vancouver's huge. There's a lot of places. Bars, clubs. Well, not really. It's not so much clubs. Clubs is more like of a one night stand kind of thing. But you never know, you still can meet someone in the club and it could become a long-term relationship. You never know, right? Not everybody's ratchet. Library, coffee shops, Vancouver loves coffee. Bubble tea shops, restaurants, through your friends, coworkers. Well, not, don't date in the work, you know, don't shit where you work. Because if it does go south, you're in trouble. Seawall, you could be rollerblading, you could be biking, you could be skateboarding, you can meet someone. Don't be afraid to say hi. Just say hi. Just wave, hi, smile. Doesn't hurt. They can't reject you. They can ignore you. And it's not going to hurt because you're saying hi. Maybe something happened in their day that they're upset about and they ignore you. That's fine. It has nothing to do with you. There's nothing wrong about you. If someone else has a different experience that day compared to what you're experiencing that day. If he or she waves hi to you, then guess what? You have a place to introduce yourself. You have a place to make small talk. And who knows what will come about that, right? You're going to meet people that you're not going to be interested in, that just turns you off completely, that annoys the crap out of you. If you meet one of these people that you do not like and you stop meeting people after that, then guess what? You're going to be single. You just say, hey, no more people contact. I'm just going to be on my computer all day. I'm going to be on my phone all day. If you do that, then guess what? You deserve to be single. You're not reaching out there. You're not taking a chance. Trust me, I do that myself as well. I don't take chances on people. I don't know. Maybe I'm just scared. Maybe I just like being single. Maybe single in Vancouver is fun. Am I looking for someone? I'm always looking. I'm always connecting with people. So who knows? Comment below. What's your thoughts about this? Are you single? Are you single in Vancouver? What's single being like in your city? Thanks for watching. Share, like, subscribe. I'll link the Vancouver Talks Single in Vancouver's video below, as well on this end screen here. So check it out. Impsquared out.